guess about a month after or so. And, you know, I was told I wasn't supposed to work, but, you know, I'm a self-employed photographer in my own business, so I needed to somehow keep a bit of an income in. So I had a few clients that were on the books since before the accident, so I decided to keep them and not accept any others. And this one particular client was some location photography at their business. It was two women who have a business in Gastown, and they needed some portraits done of them in their store for their promotions, their website, etc. Right. So I go to meet them. One is great. She's really natural. She's really easygoing. You know, a breeze. Didn't really have to give her much direction to get her comfortable in front of the camera and get something out of her that was really usable. But unfortunately, her partner was completely the opposite. So I really needed to somehow get her relaxed, get her to smile, get her to not think she's about to have her photo taken and there's a camera pointed at her and there's a light there and all these things, right? Really an uncomfortable person in front of the camera. So I tried all the tricks I usually do. Nothing was really working. And so finally, I improvised, and I made it way worse. You know, I said the wrong thing. It was a bit inappropriate. Just kind of took it the wrong direction that made her more uncomfortable, basically. And you know, it sort of became a bit of a disaster. And you know, I don't think they ever used her photos. That's for sure. I've looked; they're not on the website. I don't think they were too pleased. And, you know, what can you do? I mean, I wasn't thinking straight, you know. I wasn't able to sort of filter what was coming out of my mouth quickly enough with my head, my brain. So, oops.